In this feature of the week, I will explain you why it is important to scale continuous covariates in a statistical model. Covariates, such as weight, age, or creatinine clearance, describe physical and biological properties. Experiments and trials should be constructed in a way that individuals have similar characteristics. But very often it is not the case, and differences between them may distort true nature of a response to some drugs. Usually a trial cannot be changed, and we have to use statistical models because they can explain some intra-individual variability of parameters or even the cause-effect relationship between covariates and the parameter. In Monolix interface, the default covariate model is the exponential model, where a covariate is added linearly to the log transform individual parameter. In Monolix, I can easily add the power law model by clicking on the covariate and add log transform covariate. If I edit it, you can see that by default, the covariate value is scaled. In general, the power law model in Monolix looks like this. Let me now explain you why we use the scaling by default. There are two main reasons. First, it increases the confidence in the estimation of the parameters, because adding a covariate can introduce a collinearity in the model. It is a very strong correlation between the covariate and the parameter, and as a result, it increases standard errors of the population parameters. Scaling is a method to decrease this effect. The second reason is to give more realistic interpretation to parameters. For example, I have a simple one-compartment model with a volume and clearance as parameters, and my dataset contains information about the weight of every individual. Scaling value will impact how I interpret the VPOC parameter, that is, the volume of the compartment. If I take WTPOP equal to 1, which actually means that I don't scale the weight, then the VPOP is the typical volume of an individual of weight 1. Is it a typical human weight? Not really. And if I take, for example, 70 kilograms as WTPOP, then VPOP corresponds to the typical volume of a realistic individual in the population. Let's see now how it works in practice. First, I will compare two Monolix runs, one without scaling and one with the default scaling using Monolix, which is weighted mean. Weighted mean takes into account the number of observations for each individual. Then I will show you that scale or not to scale is not the only dilemma. Also, the scaling value itself is very important. Usually, the scaling is done by a typical human value, such as, for example, 70 kilograms for weight, or with the sample average. But these values are not the optimal. Actually, the weighted mean used in Monolix gives better results in terms of the confidence of parameter estimation. So let's go to Monolix to see it. In Monolix, I have already defined my PK model and I have chosen the initial parameter, so now I'm in the statistical model and task tab. In the section for the individual model, I added the log transformation of the weight. I will edit now this covariate. The scaled value is the weighted mean by default. If I hover on the name of the covariate, I can see all the statistics. Minimum value, maximum, mean, median, and of course weighted mean. In the first Simulix run, I will remove the scaling, so I set the scaled value to 1. I accept and I add this covariate to the volume. Now I can run the simulation. Let's look at the correlation matrix in the results tab. The population, volume, parameter, and beta are negatively correlated, and this correlation is really strong because the value is close to minus 1. In the population parameter section, I can see that standard errors are also very high. So let's see what happens if I add scaling. I go back to the statistical model and task tab, and I added the covariate. In place of 1, I add the weighted mean. I accept and I save the project under different name so that I don't overwrite the previous results. Now I run the simulation again. Let's look at the correlation matrix. The scaling practically removed the correlations. The value is now of order 10 to the minus 2. As a consequence, the confidence of the estimation of the volume parameter will be much better. In fact, standard errors decreased 10 times. So now let me show you that it is also very important to choose which value we use for scaling. To do this, I'm going to use Sycamore to compare Monolix runs with different scaling values of weight. So project number 4 is with scaling value equal to 70, which is a typical human weight, and project number 3 uses sample mean. I ordered columns by decreasing value of the standard errors of the volume parameter, which is in this row. As I showed you before, without scaling, the standard errors are very high and we are at the 40%. Now, using a typical weight of a human, so 70 kilograms, improved a lot the standard errors, so the confidence in the parameter estimation, and using a mean from the sample improves the value even better. But still, this value is worse than the weighted mean, which is used by default in Monolix. In fact, if I look at the correlation between VPOP parameter and beta for these two models, the difference is very big. On the left, I have a model where I use the scaling based on the simple mean, and on the right, I have a model with the weighted mean scaling. The value for the correlation is 10 times smaller. So remember to scale your covariates to improve the performance of your model. Thank you for listening and have a good weekend.